Okay, I need two brave volunteers. Thank you. You didn't even get to hear me say, usually volunteers don't get hurt.
Okay.
You're not afraid?
No.
You're tough. What's your name?
Tanya.
Tanya, right this way, please. I'll come back for number two in a second, but Tanya's got this side under control. Right this way, please. Take your left hand, place it right against the sun. And look this way. This is called a photo op. Perfect. That's an ancient tradition, photo ops here in Jerusalem. Okay, I need one more volunteer. Oh, I love that. What a great relationship you guys have. Turkish democracy, I love that. I didn't want to say that, but... Take your right hand and place it right there. Guys, whatever you do, don't push this wall back. Great, okay. This wall is under deep trouble. I may have to seek political asylum in Turkey. You never know. Okay. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages, welcome to the Western Wall. For the rest of our time together today, as we walk north, on our right side is going to be the Western Wall. Now, you may have heard the term Herodian stones. Let me show you what that looks like. It's a flat middle with a carved double border around it. There's no functional purpose for that design at all. It's merely the aesthetics. Herod liked the way it looked, unique to the land of Israel 2,000 years ago, not repeated elsewhere in the Roman Empire. Now, at the very beginning of our tour, just in case you came late, I'll remind you, I confess to everyone that I originally come from the Big Apple, New York City, as if you couldn't have told from this accent. Coming from New York, though, you can imagine I'm used to things that are very big. Everything in New York is kind of supersized. But there's nothing in my New York experience that could have possibly prepared me for the one single stone that I'm standing in front of. This is one stone stretching from here, hi, to here, hi,
one single stone,
13 and a half meters long. Guys, you can come back now, you did a great job, thank you. 13 and a half meters long. Originally it stood 3.5 meters high. When the Romans destroyed the temple in the year 70, they tried to push the stone over, couldn't get it to budge. So they started chipping away at the top. So these stones are later filled. So this is the 3.5 meters high. And it's 4.5 meters deep, made of limestone. How much would something like this weigh? Oh, we're gonna get there in a second. Okay, can I share an interesting cross-cultural experience with you? Whenever I'm not guiding across the country, I guide here part-time. This is now tour number 535 in 3.5 years. I've noticed something. When I ask the question, how much this weighs, if I have an overwhelming majority of Americans in my group, someone always yells out, a lot. And technically it's true. I would have to give you full credit. But I don't know why, culturally though, it happens like that. This is a lot. It's 570 tons a lot. This is larger than any single stone of the Great Pyramid of Egypt. There are very few cranes in our modern world today that could pick up a stone like this, lift it, move it, and put it down. So now we come to your question. See, you're being nice about it. Usually people in the back get like really, they get like, so, kind of Mr. Smarty Pants, how did they do it? The largest stones were never lifted. Rather, they were quarried nearby and slid into place on the level they needed to be at. You slide a stone by using teams of oxen, pulleys. Guys, if you could just move over a little bit and let these ladies out. Pulleys to offset the weight and have it go over a series of logs that created an effect like a conveyor belt. Now remember, the stones that you see outside are teeny tiny stones. You know, like 2.5 to 20 tons. They're like pebbles compared to this. This is not the bottom level though. You see there's a level right here. And right where I'm standing, it goes down for 16 meters, 48 feet. As we walk north, we'll be walking on a flat grade, but the bedrock rises the entire time. So that distance becomes less and less. These stones are not held together by cement. That was my concern, that they'd be pushed back. Each level was set 2 centimeters. That's less than 1 inch behind the one below it. That way, when you were standing next to it 2,000 years ago, it didn't give you the optical illusion of coming down to your head. Now, is there anyone curious about these holes?
Yeah.
Yes.
Not part of the original design, and not used to move the stones. I did hear a brilliant theory from a young boy from Toronto last week. He suggested that it was the world's first climbing wall. And I thought to myself, what a great idea. I wish our Ministry of Tourism would think of stuff like
the
that.
Business for you.
But no. Definitely. Rather, during the Byzantine period, since this spot was low and collected rainwater in the winter, some genius said, let's put a reservoir. They took plaster and slapped it up on the walls. Problem was, the plaster then was still very weak, and the limestone was highly polished, and it slid right off. So they began carving these holes. And in all of these holes, they put these pieces of stone. They used this stone to anchor a second wall right here, and they were then able to plaster it on the outside. And voila, we have a reservoir. Now, let's get back to 570 tons for a second. We all know that that's a lot. But level with me. If you guys are anything at all like me, you just know that it's more than 569 tons and less than 571 tons. Who cares? I'm going to give you a picture of what that looks like in our world today. You've all been on an airplane?
Mm-hmm.
Perfect. Take two jumbo jets, fully loaded with fuel, a full crew, all the passengers, your luggage, your carry-on bags, your laptops, iPads, Kindles, sandwiches and snacks that you brought on board, even if people on your flights bought stuff in duty-free, I mean, not you, but them, not close to 570 tons. It's amazing. Now, in a few moments, we're going to continue walking north. We're going to come to five short steps. Immediately afterwards, on the right, is a cemented over arched area. It's referred to as Warren's Gate, named after Captain Warren. 2,000 years ago, it was one of four entrances on the western side of the Temple Mount. When the Romans destroyed the temple in 70, an opening, guys, if you could just move over a drop, an opening was created there. In Hebrew, it's referred to as the Me'ara, the cave. That cave served as the central synagogue for the Jewish community here in Jerusalem from the time of the early Muslim period in 638 all the way up until the time of the First Crusades in 1099. Immediately afterwards is a very special area, and you'll see women praying. Actually, those women that are coming by had just finished.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekpak, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Eli Sekpak.